Hey, I'm Willie. I'm the supervising engineer out here at Irvine Park Railroad. It's our little train right here.
Anywhere you go, anywhere you go, give it all. Anywhere you say,
where did we go today?
We went
to a hidden zoo.
You cut me off. What we're calling a hidden zoo, but it's not really a hidden zoo.
It was hidden. I didn't know about it, so it's hidden.
Because it's on Google Maps. Anyway, so we went to the Orange County Zoo, which is in Irvine Park.
But not the one with the big balloon.
No. So it was in Orange, and it's called Irvine Park because it's named after the Irvine family.
So this park has an entrance fee. It's $3 to get in during the weekdays and
$5 on the weekends. And $5 on the weekends.
The zoo, the hidden zoo, it's $2 to get in, right? And like kids one and under are free?
Two and under, one and under, something like that. Lydia was free. And it's not a really, really big zoo, but I mean, they got some big animals in there. It's a pretty good size. You could spend an hour there. So there's like one main area that we went to, and it has the zoo, it has the little lake. And it has the train.
So hey, I'm Willie. I'm the supervising engineer out here at Irvine Park Railroad. It's our little train right here, our 1/3 scale railroad that runs on a 2-foot gauge track. It's a C.P. Huntington by Chance Rides, which is based in Wichita, Kansas. C.P. Huntington was a real train that existed in the 1860s, still exists today. You can see it at the museum in Sacramento. The train rides here 7 days a week. We are closed some holidays, weather permitting, of course. A little 12-minute trip in the park. It's about a mile long. You learn some history about the park and enjoy nature and whatnot throughout the ride.
Ready?
So we went on the little train ride. It's a little 12-minute loop, and it was $6 per adult. One and under are free?
Yeah, it's a 12-minute loop, mm-hmm. and...
They talk to you a little bit about the things that are around there. They talk about the lake. They talk about the type of fish that there are in the lake, because you can go fishing.
It's really cool because you have a train conductor that's sitting in the front, and the whole experience is awesome. It seats two adults per row, or if you're sitting with a baby, three. So we did go to this park a long time ago, but it was for like the pumpkin patch.
We did go to the pumpkin patch, yeah.
And then we had like a little mini barbecue right there, but we didn't know about the zoo at the time, and we didn't know about like the lake and stuff, so it was quite a cool surprise.
I don't know how much the pony rides were, I didn't see, but I did see that they have two different sides. So there's a side where the parent can walk the child, or the kids can ride a pony a little bit faster being led by one of their guides.
Cool.
So that seemed pretty interesting. We saw kids of all ages on there.
All ages.
I have no idea.
They paddle call boats.
Those aren't paddle boats. It's the tricycle thing.
It says right here.
I know, they call them paddle boats. Those are not paddle boats. Those are tricycle things.
They're paddle boat tricycle things.
It's the tricycle. That's where they also have the Surrey and bike rentals.
I have no idea what a Surrey is.
It's that thing with the seat, with the benches, the two benches.
I think they just call them bike rentals.
No, those are Surreys.
Okay, Surreys.
You know, like that song. We just scratched the surface on what you can do at Irvine Regional Park. There's actually tons to do there.
I was astonished how many things there are to do at the Irvine Park. Ready to list them?
Da, 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 da.
Here we go. There is barbecues,
bike trails,
bike rentals,
botanical preserves,
it's dog friendly,
horse trails,
family picnic areas,
fishing,
concessions,
hiking trails,
horseback riding,
horseshoe pits,
interpretive center,
paddle boat rentals,
playground,
pony ride,
train ride,
party pavilion,
scenic overlook,
picnic table,
softball fields,
restrooms,
and a bunch of volleyball poles. All right, so that's it.
I think we are definitely going to go back for the pumpkin patch. I know that we did that before. I think it'd be fun to take the munchkin to. Maybe go sometime at Christmas also to see what that's about, because it said something about a Christmas train ride, and so I'm curious.
I mean, I know it's not hidden, but it seems like it's hidden, you know? I took a drone and I flew it up in the air, and all you can see is literally like just trees and plants, so you know. We're gonna put the address to the park in the description, but if you get lost off the Fire Freeway, just keep going east down Jamboree. It's, you know, till it ends.
We'll have to see how it goes. We might have to do that over again.